Surprisingly, I feel pretty good.
Representative Trey Martinez Fisher of San Antonio is one of five Texas House Democrats who tested positive for COVID-19 while in D.C. to lobby for voting protections.
I've been productive. I worked all day yesterday. I've worked most of the day today.
All the representatives who tested positive were fully vaccinated, and Martinez Fisher says he's thankful he was.
That vaccine has certainly prepared me and prepared my defense mechanisms to really withstand the brunt of that virus.
It's called a breakthrough infection, and they're both rare and expected.
But right now, getting people vaccinated is the number one priority.
Dr. Pratheek Kulkarni is an infectious disease professor at Baylor College of Medicine in Houston. He says vaccines lower the odds of getting COVID or spreading it, but their greatest benefit is preventing serious illness.
The odds of getting very sick, ending up in the hospital, or dying from COVID go way down.
Around 230,000 Americans have died from COVID since January. Just under 800 of them were fully vaccinated. That's less than 1%.
A lot of this Delta variant spread is being driven by a younger population, but it's not necessarily because of their inherent age. It's because of their vaccination status.
COVID hospitalizations have more than doubled in Texas in the last month, and health officials expect it to get worse.
And that is just so unfortunate because it's entirely preventable. It is entirely preventable.
Breakthrough infections can lower confidence, but vaccines are still the best way to keep yourself and others out of the hospital.
It's not as if we don't know what to do. It's not as if there's not a prevention or not a cure.
Let's remember that we're all in this together.
In Fort Worth, I'm William Joy.